I'm coming! It's all right! I'm coming!
It was a crazy drunken dream, and yet it was more than that. It was the truth, a suppressed memory unearthed by the Andersons' moonshine. I was there, an out-of-body observer. This was the night Alice and I had arrived at Bright Falls, the night Alice had disappeared. I had a chance to find out what had happened. I remember being surprised to see the cabin dark. Alice would have never turned the lights off. I remember thinking, I caught a glimpse of her form underwater, sinking into the darkness. Diving after her was the last vague memory I had of that night. After that, the next thing I could remember was waking up behind the wheel of the crash car and finding the first pages of the manuscript. Beyond this lost memory, there was nothing. I had to follow the footsteps of my past self to find out what had happened that night. I couldn't find her in all that blackness. I must have thought she drowned.
Alice!
Jagger had Alice, and so she had me.
Alice!
I'd been easy prey.
Look at the cabin. Is there someone at the window?
Alice?
Maybe she didn't drown after all. Maybe she's inside.
Alice!
Yes.
The dark presence had touched me. She had dug her nails into my brain and used me, made me her puppet.
She must be here somewhere. Maybe upstairs in the study.
Alice!
Yes, that's where she is. You can apologize.
Alice!
You laugh at the whole thing together and put it
back. Alice!
You. She's not here. You were foolish to think so. No, she's dead. She drowned.
No, no, no!
It's your fault your wife is dead. You are guilty. All she wanted was to help you, right? You killed her.
Ah!
Oh, hush. There's still hope. Cauldron Lake is a special place. Here, you have the power to change things. She wanted you to write. I will tell you what to do. You can write her back. The story will come true, and all will be well again.
She had Alice, and the manuscript was the ransom for her.
Yes. I'll write. I'll fix it. I'll bring her back.
I'd written for days, a week, almost a complete manuscript of the novel entitled Departure. Jagger had been my editor, whispering in my ear, making sure that the unfolding story would make her more and more powerful. I thought I was saving Alice. Even with the cobweb she put in my head, some part of me had been aware enough to write my escape into the story, to bring a light with the cabin to release me before I could finish. To interrupt the horror story before the ending, where darkness consumed everything and everyone. Zane was weak and far away, but I had written him into the story, and his light had been enough to set me free.
It isn't here now. I'm here because it was written. I want the light to set you free. You must hurry. We'll know I'm here. It will be back soon. It stole the skin of my armor a long time ago. She looks so old.
I had woken up, confused and groggy, my mind consumed by darkness and fear. All I could do was to escape.
Oh God.
taken its toll. I was barely conscious and fading fast. It had to have cost Zane terribly, thrown him even deeper into whatever dark place he now haunted. But he had managed to weaken the dark presence, kept me safe that night.
That's right, James Joyce. It's your fault, and you're gonna pay for it.
Previously on Alan Wake, under the influence of the Dark Presence, I wrote a horror story that is coming true. Jagger had been my editor, making sure that the unfolding story would make her more and more powerful. Some part of me had been aware enough to write my escape into the story.
Together we can create something absolutely wonderful.
The lake, it does something to the works of art created here. It's still come true. My mom gave me this old light switch. Alice is being kept in a dark prison. I need to find Cynthia Weaver to fix this.
It's your fault, and you're gonna pay for it.
Well, we're expecting a record crowd from the neighboring counties, naturally. We hope to break the record set by last year's Moose Fest in our neighboring town, Watery. Ladies and gentlemen, some people have asked me, what's the big deal about Deerfest? And I think that this sums it up. It's about friendship and community. We've got a great party coming up, though. Let's dress our holes in until tomorrow. Get through the night in one piece, all right?
Someone will come for it when the time is right. Thomas said so. He wrote it. The key is insurance. It's my job to keep it safe. Safe in the light. Or is it a light?
Hello.
All the manuscript pages were gone. The FBI agent had taken them.
I think my tongue just took a crap in my mouth. Phew. Oh, wait, we're in jail now? Oh, hell, this is not good.
That about sums it up.
Oh, I am never drinking again.
I need to talk to Weaver. She's the one in the song, the Lady of the Light.
What, the crazy lady? Ugh, whatever you say, Al, but we're stuck here. They're not good.
I had some reading to do first, Sheriff. And let me tell you, it was an interesting read. Well, I've got you now, Raymond Chandler. It's all here. All the evidence, including conspiracy to murder a federal agent. There's no way you're walking out of here. You hear me in there, Brett Easton Ellis? Huh?
Agent Nightingale, I want to talk to your superior.
Well, we all want things, Sheriff. I wanted my... Look, that's not possible right now.
Agent Nightingale, I insist.
Wake, what's wrong?
Lady, are you stupid? It's a trick. It's an obvious trick.
Okay, I've had enough of this crap. Wake, I'm gonna trust you with this.
You're joking.
Agent Nightingale, your opinion would matter more if you were sober and if I actually believed you were here on official business.
Whoa! Get back in the cell, Stephen King! The only way you're leaving this place is over my dead...
Wait a minute.
Oh my God!
Light. We need light. It's the only way to fight this thing.
In my office. I've got your things there. Follow me.
Oh, man. We're sitting ducks with the lights out.
Stay cool. I can get the emergency power on.
Only in the light, and I need to find Cynthia Weaver. She can help me stop this.
Light. Check. Cynthia. She lives in the old decommissioned power plant. I can get you there pretty quickly in the rescue chopper. Come on, let's get back to your friend. Wheeler, I need you to stay here.
What? No!
We're going to fetch our ride, but I have friends who need to be warned about this, and I can't be in two places at once. I need your help.
Well, okay.
Here's a list of people and phone numbers. I need you to call them and tell them you have a message from me. Night Springs, okay? They'll know what to do.
Night Springs? Like the TV show? Gotcha. Oh, hey, that radio guy is on the list, Maine. Who's Frank Breaker? He related to you?
My dad.
Hey, is this like a secret society?
Can you do this? You'll be safe here. The backup power's on. These guys need to be alerted, just in case we don't come back.
You'll come back for me though, right?
As soon as we get the chopper ready. Thanks, Wheeler. I owe you one. Okay, let's go, Wake. Through the back.
My hangover wants pizza. You think there's any way I can order one out?
Oh, hell. Whatever took Nightingale must have broken the gate controls. We can't reach the gate's control box from here. We need to get to the other side over the rooftop.
I'll go. I'll open the gate for you once I'm across. You stay here in the light and cover me, Sheriff, okay?
To reach the rooftop to get to the other side of the broken gate.
Hey, Sheriff! Your password. Night Springs? What's that all about?
It's a stupid joke we have. That Bright Falls is the original inspiration for the TV show. This town can get weird at times. Never this weird, though. You need to bypass the damage control box.
What am I, an electrician? Hold on!
Freeze!
Sarah.
Someone's messed with the fuse box, but you should be able to jury-rig it while I find the keys.
I already got electrocuted once today. How about I look for the keys and you get burned for a change?
Fine. They should be in the clerk's office on the other side of the building, near the main entrance.
The message was for Barry. He was getting worried at the station. He wanted us to hurry.
The keys aren't upstairs, Wake.
I'm just gonna take a quick look.
Sheriff. I got the keys.
Barry?
Why isn't he inside?
Oh, God! Oh, God!
Barry! Look out! Barry, move!
Inside, Wake. He's okay.
The storefront's blocked. Come on, Wake. Let's go around. We can meet him in the back.
We can make it through the bookstore. Wheeler should be waiting for us in the backyard. Oh, hi, Doc. I've got it. Don't worry about it.
Sarah, about time somebody showed up. All the shooting in the air is idiotic. One of these days, they'll kill somebody. And over Deerfest.
I know. Go back to bed. He's got a point, Wade. Look, this town can't take this.
It's me they want. The sooner I get out of here, the sooner you can all get back to life as usual.
I hope you're right. Come on, let me get this door open.
Wait, you got the keys to the bookstore?
Perks of being the sheriff. A girl needs to get around. They're really taking advantage of your presence here, Wake. I heard they're selling a lot of your Alex Casey books.
Right now, I'm not a big fan of my own writing.
I don't see Barry.
Look, wait, maybe that's him. That's the way to the chopper. I'm gonna give Pastor Howard a piece of my mind about this lock. I told him to get it fixed.
Here they come.
Physical labor. Let's take a break.
Here
they come! Let's take a break! free fatty acids are good for your heart.
Okay, it's open. Let's go, Wake. We're almost there. We'll have to go through the basement to get to the parking lot.
Yeah, there's no way going through the crypt will turn out to be a bad idea.
Bright Falls General Store is now my favorite place in the entire world. See this headlamp? It's like a superpower. I can just look at one of those things and they die. It's my flaming eye of Mordor.
Mordor.
I wish I could say that.
Yeah.
Hey, I want a headlamp.
Last one.
Bastard.
Just up ahead. I'll need a while to prep the tape.
Just get me a Weaver, Sheriff.
You're taking a big chance on a local crazy lady, Al. I hope you're right about her, or we can kiss this town goodbye.
Something about the chain for the door to open. Something about the chain for the door to open.
Hey,
And here's a new song from a band that...
Let's go.
recognize the logo on the power plant sign. I'd seen a version of it painted all over the area, signifying hidden caches of supplies.
Hold it right there!
Miss Weaver! Cynthia! I'm a friend!
Prove it!
You knew Zane! Thomas Zane! You're the Lady of the Light in the song! You can help me!
About time! Young man, I've been waiting a very long time for you.
It's in the well-lit room.
Excuse me?
What you need to drive the darkness back. Well-lit rooms at the dam. I've built the room to keep it safe.
Will it help me find Alice? Will it get me back to the cabin? Fine, let's go. I can get my friends to come back with the helicopter.
She had been living this insanity for decades. See the kill switch that would cut the power to the transformer yard. Now I had to find a way to reach it. I could see the kill switch that would cut the power to the transformer yard. Now, I had to find a way to reach it. Wi-Fi passage should now be good to go.
This way, young man. Follow me. Come, come. The pipe's empty now. We're ready to go. This way. We need to go.
I knew them both, Tom and Barbara. Such a crush on him. Such a beautiful man. I was jealous. There was a part of me that was maybe a little glad when she had the accident. And then Tom started writing and woke the darkness up. He tried to bring it back, but you can't do that. There are no free rides like that.
I'm starting to realize that.
In that case, young man, perhaps you're a smarter man than Tom was. The witch looked like her, but it wasn't. Barbara was sweet. He didn't understand until it was too late. He tried to undo it, wrote himself, her, everything he'd ever written out of the world. Oh, he was so famous. And afterward, no one knew. He left only one thing behind him, in case it happened again. Insurance. He trusted me. Or perhaps used me a little. Tom knew how I felt. Knew I wouldn't refuse him. I built the well-lit room right there. It's been waiting for you. We are characters trapped in a story. And none of us will survive to see the end. This isn't stopped. She'll twist the story to her own bargains.
How do you know all this?
Tom, that's the way he wrote it. He still talks to me. In television, beyond, from below. We've both been touched by the darkness, young man. He saved us both with light. The darkness is with him. Here's a stay. This pipe will take us directly to the well-lit room.
Okay, I need to call my friends, tell them where we're going.
Hello? Ow!
Barry, we're headed to the dam in one of the pipes. Meet us there.
Okay, I'll tell Sarah.
Is Sarah now? We gotta go see if they're okay.
They're probably dead. You must reach the well-lit room. This is no time to be a selfish idiot.
That's my best friend!
Well, be a fool. I'll use the pipe. I'll meet you at the dam if you make it.
least I didn't have to worry about her. She knew how to stay safe. As far as I could tell, the wreck was empty.
Thank you.
button. We're almost there. There's an entrance into the dam at the top. What's the plan, Wade?
Well, Weaver's crazy, but she's got something Zane left behind. Something to fix this.
Gee, could you be a little more vague?
Thomas Zane? Seriously? Might as well be Paul Bunyan or Bigfoot.
Yeah, well, he was real.
I have looked after the well-lit room for many, many years now. There's no shadow in the well-lit room. The power is fail-safe, and all the bulbs are numbered and changed regularly based on their make and model.
Right.
Need changing soon, and I don't want to climb up the ladder to change them because it's very late and I'm tired. And if you take it, I won't have to do it anymore.
The page was autobiographical, a memory from my childhood. But I didn't write this. It was a page written by Thomas Zane. None of them were supposed to exist anymore.
Alan, 7 years old, would fight sleep to the bitter end. When he did sleep, he soon woke up, screaming, the nightmares fresh in his mind. One evening, his mother, sitting by his bed, offered him an old light switch. She called it the clicker, and flicking the switch would turn on a magical light that would drive the beast away. To imbue the talisman with all possible power, she added that it had been given to her by Alan's father. Alan never knew him, and anything of his took on mythical proportions in his mind. With the clicker firmly in his hand, Alan finally slept like a baby. Now, almost 30 years later, Alan thought of this as he stood on the rim of Cauldron Lake, the clicker in his hand. He took a deep breath and jumped.
My mind swirled. I'd given the clicker to Alice, yet it was here. Zane had written it into existence in a story I had written. I can get to her now. I can finish this.